It can be boring or difficult to animate a character without a nice model surface preview, but this is often overlooked. Switching to previs mode can be hard on your computer and reduces your frame rate. I'm Pierrick from P2 Design, and this is how I create nice looking rigged character without sacrificing performances. The Basal View mode is the mode where you will have the best performances. We can tweak this preview through the viewport shadings options. But how can we get something that seems rendered sticking to this view mode? As said in the introduction, switching to preview mode can drastically reduce your performances. So how do we get from this base solid view mode to this nice looking model with a consistent frame rate? The first thing is to edit our viewport shading. As an example, I will use the character Trident from my animation course Alive. You can also get this character for free on p2designacademy.com. The first step is to edit the viewport shading option. In the drop-down menu, the first thing I will do is to activate the texture mode. When you do so, the active texture is overlaid upon your shading, in this case on this beige matcap. I get a pretty dark result, so I will switch to flat. So far it doesn't look too bad, but how can I choose the texture to be displayed? When you choose texture as the color mode of the viewport shading, Blender uses the active texture from the character's material. For this model it uses the diffuse color by default, but if I just select the roughness map, you can see that it switches in the 3D viewport. Same goes for the normal map. To set the texture as active, you simply need to select it last, exactly as you will do with vertices or an object. The selected nodes are outlined in orange, the active node is outlined in white. To only show my character, I disabled the overlays. You can do that with Alt+Shift+Z. Let's check again the viewport shading drop-down menu. Here we can activate shadows and cavity. The shadow option is very interesting, especially to read the volume of your character. And the cavity will bring contrast to the valleys and edges of your model. With those two activated, we get a shading that is a little more readable and appealing. But how do I get to this result? And no, I'm not cheating, I'm still using solid view mode. Before we get into it, I'd just like to give a shout out to CG Boost. They just launched a new challenge and I'll be part of it. There are tons of prizes, including my courses, and they're running a special discount of 20% on the Cubic World course for the duration of the challenge. Links in the video description. As said before, this is the final result we are attempting to get. And this is how my character looks when I'm rendering it in cycle. It's pretty close, right? So what we are going to do is to bake the cycle rendering onto a simple previs texture. The process is pretty simple. Let's just begin with this simple scene. Here's the result rendered in cycle. The cube and the plane are a single object with a material. You do need a material. And you do need your mesh to be unwrapped. I will open the material editor and check my object material. To bake the texture, you simply node an image texture node. Once you created that, you need to create a texture. The resolution doesn't matter. And to bake on this specific texture, you just need to make sure that the node is active. Since I'm using the texture in the viewport shading, the object turns black. To bake the render result onto this object, we need to use cycles. So you may have heard about baking when it comes to baking normal maps, for example. But by default, when we open the bake options, the bake type is set to combined. And all the shading information will be baked on the model. So let's click bake and see what happens. You will see a progression bar opening. Baking can be pretty slow, so don't panic. After a moment, the baking is done, and this is what I have in solid view mode. Here is the render view mode, and here is the solid view mode with textures enabled. And this is what the baked textures looks like. We can see the lightning and shadows information, but also the indirect lightning baked on the surface. That's really cool. So let's do the same thing with our character. If you have a character with multiple material, you will have to do that for each material. Create a texture in each material, make it active, and then bake. The first thing I will do is select my Trident rig and put it in rest pose. This way I prevent the arms to cast shadows on the body. these typos should generate more neutral result. On the left, I have my character's material open. I will add a new node and choose a texture node. I will choose image texture and create a new texture. Give it a relevant name and increase a bit the resolution. Now, if you're not using UDIMMs, you're already good to go. But if you're using UDIMMs, you will need to modify the picture properties in the image editor. As you can see, when I choose my base color, I'm using UDIMMs for this character. One texture is used for the head and the limbs, while the second texture is used for the torso and the weapons. I will now open the new texture I created. By default, it uses the source generated. I will switch that to UDIMM tiles. And now Blender's let me know that it's missing a data showing this pink colored texture. I just need to create a second UDIMM tile by clicking the plus button. From there, I'm good to go. I will switch back to my shader, make sure that the Trident Previs is active, switch to render mode and switch to cycle. Now, my scene is not lit, so I won't have any information but black to be baked. In my world shader, I will load an HDRI. I will select the background, press Ctrl T using the node wrangler, and I will load an HDRI from Polyhaven. On Polyhaven, you can find pro quality textures, HDRI and models. All of this awesomeness for free. So here's my character rendered in cycle with this HDRI. In the render option, I will go to film and choose transparent to make the background transparent. The idea is to bake what we see on our character. What I do like to do is just to add a couple of light in the back, because with the bake, the shadows will be a little too dark. Adding a couple of area light with low intensity will give a more homogeneous global illumination for our character. Once I'm done with that, I will switch back to solid view mode, select my character, go to the baking option, make sure I choose combined and click bake. After a few seconds, here is the result. Here you can see the viewport in solid view mode, and with this baked texture, my character is way more appealing. I used the same method to bake this mech. I didn't use it for this tutorial because the baking was a little longer. But here you can see the comparison between the baked texture and its default diffuse color. This is the end of this video. Hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you in the next one.